Good day, no? So this will be my first entry for the TNS3, and your TNS3 will be known as the Geology for Civil Engineers. So right now we'll be discussing the chapter 1 of the TNS3, no? So the content of this chapter 1 will be about the earth and geology, no? So on the chapter 1, so mo ni siyang atong outline, and we will be discussing about geology, engineering geology, then things we need to know about the earth, which is more likely geology class is somewhat study of kuan na siya, by in literal means kuan gyud siya, no, kanang study of earth. So we will be study anything, no? Everything about the earth, no? So including the etymology. So we say etymology, ang sinugdanan siya ang pangalan, ganung gitawag siya earth. Then chronology, the history niya, no? History siya ang gikan siyang evolution, how was the earth was formed, something like that. Then the physical characteristics, siya ang composition, the materials, the elements. Then the orbit and rotation, as we know that the earth is revolving or naa siya'y sarili niyang rotation, including the moon, no? Naa siya'y yahang sarili niyang satellite. Then we have this what we called as the Earth-Moon system, no? So unsay ilahang relation between the earth and the moon, no? How does it affects each other, no? So how does the moon affects the earth, or the earth affects the moon? Then we have the hydrosphere of the earth, as we know that the earth contains water, or the ocean water. So there will be a study about that one, no? This separate study for the hydrosphere, no? Then the atmosphere, so somewhat because of the presence of air, or let us say vapor, sa tuang kuan, sa tuang atmosphere. So atuang atmosphere naapod siya ay kanya-kanyang layers, no? Then last one is the human geography. As we know that the earth is not complete without its habitants, no? So isa sa mga kanang pinaka murag ruler, or let us say murag nanguna, no, sa mga habitants is the human. Okay, so that is the content, no? So the outline content for the chapter 1. So let us begin, no? So first of all, let us ask what is geology, no? So what is geology therefore? So ang geology class, sama sa mga mention earlier, that is geology is the study about the earth, no? So study of earth, then the materials of which it is made, the structure of those materials, and the processes acting upon them, which includes the study of organisms that have inhabited to it, no? So appeal na po, parehas ato mo tong gi-include na to ang human geography. Then the important part of geology is to understand the history of our planet. So if we kwan daw sa masigisultre, the better we can understand the earth's history, the better we can foresee how events and processes of the past might influence the future, no? So kwan class in a murag, so therefore bot pasabot niya kung makabalo lang ta kung unsay background sa earth. So there might be, no, a possibility nga ang atuang past class maka-learn ta sa tong past, and we will might therefore kanang ma-predict nato unsaon niya pag-influence ang future, no? For example, if this case nahitabo na ni siya sa past, posible nga ingon ani pud ang mahitabo sa future, no? Parehas aning climate change, no? Mo ginangilang big time kay nila nga gi-studyhan about sa geology, no? The climate change. Ilahang gikuan nila, gitansya nila kung how is it possible nga basin o by the near future class, no, ang earth na ay posibilidad nga muagi siya og katastrophe. And kang ilahang but pasabot nga katastrophe, posible nga mubalik ang ice age, no? So mo na ang ilahang gina-predict. Then napoy somewhat mga theories about this one, no, kadong sa earth, sa kuan daw evolution sa sun. So ang sun is somewhat si kuan lang daw ay considered as pinaka nearest star, no? So therefore ang sana to posible nga mag-evolve pod siya, no? So, then mga pila pa ka billions of years nga mahitabo pa na siya, no, nga ang mag-evolve ang kuan, ang evolution sa sun. So there might be a possibility nga ma-annihilate, ma-kuan daw ka ng ma-hurot ang tanan mga let us say living creature diri sa earth kay tungod sa exist no, nikadako ang sun no. Okay, so napalagta sa geology nga definition class no, so murag dagana kag kung mga gipang touch nga mga topic. But anyway, so let us go forward no. So if we say geology, kung makita niyo diri sa diagram, the geology covers niya ang earth history, then the earth materials and the earth processes. So ato na siya isahon no. So let us discuss about the earth history. So what's the function, para asa dining earth history no? So climate change has become the most concern nowadays. Therefore, geologists are working to learn about the past climates of earth and how they have changed across time no. So sama sa kung gi-mention earlier, so ilahang gitansya if this type of climate nag-exist ba ni siya sa una no, then ilahang gitry nila predict what's next no, what's next para sa to ang climate no. So there might be ilahang yung ginahunaw na nila the catastrophe na nga posible nga mahitabo no. So gusto man nato nga mag-survive no, so mo nang ilahang gipangitaan nila og study kung kano sa unsaon na siya pag kuha nato no, unsaon nato pag survive about this matter no, the climate change. Then with regards to earth history, so this historical geology news information is valuable to understand how our current climate is changing and what the results might be in the future no. So ako mutuon na pagkuha ng climate change no. Okay, so far based on my experience, so murag masulti na pud nato nga lahi ra gid kayo ang kuan climate dati o climate karon no. So I think based murag sa inyo hapon, ma-feel na pud na ninyo nga sa una dili ra ang kuan, let us say ang kainit dili ra kayo siya tantong sakit no. Pero karon kay lain na mga init, mamaak naman no. And at the same time abnormal na ang kuan, ang itasay ka na mag-ulan lang gani no. So ang dati kung mag-ulan sa una malipay pa ta, karon kung mag-ulan di na ta malipay, kaya nga naman mubaha manggod no, mubaha ang ulan, simpleng ulan lang mubaha, simpleng taligsik no. So taligsik tapos kuan murag itasay tibok adlaw nga taligsik no. Holy shit, di ba siya yung mga taligsik at ang murag ulan lang gamay ba no, gamay lang ang ulan pero dugay no. So, cause na siya og baha. Okay, next. The earth materials. As we know, ang atuang earth nato is abundant with such chemicals nga usually ginagamit nato for construction. And not only for construction, also kanang for daily use, no? So, people use earth materials such as metals, aggregates, minerals, etc., no? So, therefore, geologists conduct studies to locate rocks that contain metals, minerals or elements and how to extract these raw materials with less harm to the environment no. So kita class, if ever man kung kita may in charge sa pag-extract sa materials, kinahanglan nga ato kung planuhon nato kung unsaon nato nga pag-extract anang materials nga dili po siya maka-harm sa environment. Otherwise, kung ang style nato sa pag-extract sa materials is mura latang kanang nangukay bitaw, kanang nangukay og sanina ba no, after nato mangukay, wala na, sagdaan lang nato nga nakatiwangwang no atong giukay. So it should be nga ibalik nato sa isang dating nga formation no. Okay, otherwise na siya'y mga risk no. So naagi risk ang pag-extract og materials. So in some cases class, usually kanang bitaw mag-extract silang materials, kanang magkandak pa na sila og study no. So ang magkandak og study ana ang mga geologist no. Kung let us say asa or i-locate man nila dapita, kung mag-locate na sila kung asay mga areas which is abundant of such material no. Okay, next, the same method they used in locating oil, natural gas and even groundwater no. So magkuha na sila no, magkandak na sila lag study or kana bitaw magkuha na sila mag-drilling bitaw sa ilalom, especially kanang oil. So mag-drill na sila sa ilalom or kanang magpump bitaw, kanang magbomba, similar sa kanang tubig. So they are trying to determine if naabay natural gas sa ilalom, no? Okay, natural gas, oil, so mao gina kay pinamurag pinaka-essential karon, no? Nga gina kuan, no, gina extract sa mga human, no? Okay, mao may kanang sa to pa useful, no? Mao siya murag magsilbi nga power source, no? So daghan siya gamit ang oil. Then ang kwalang ani, the problem is that ang oil manggod is kwan na siya, no? Fossil, no? So para ma-restore ang fossil, magpaabot patag pila ka billions of years usa siya ma himong fossil, no? Then dili siya billion, mag million lang yata, no? So lagi tendency class nga mahurot gid siya, no? So masulti na to class nga finite, no? Finite ang ato ang materials na to, Nadria. So buot pasabot ang finite, posible siya nga mahurot, no? So that is why kinahanglan nato siya nga maka-learn ta class, no, nga mag-recycle, no. So mag-recycle ta sa ato ang gipanggamit nga mga materials, no? Okay, so paminaw nako di na gina ma-recycle ng oil. Okay, na tendency man god nga based on the some laws of thermodynamics, nagi na siya kanang kuno matawag nato nga waste energy, no? Waste energy. After we used a certain material for para siya magsilbing makakreata o kanang work, no? So mahog gyapon nga kitong materials nga tong gigamit, mahimo nato siyang waste after nato siya magamit, no? So paresa nang kuan, no? Paresa nang tisyo. Iniguman nato gamit sa tisyo, wala na, waste na, di naman siya pwede gamiton. Paresa nang mask, no? Magsuotag mask. Kausar man na suoto ng mask. After nato masuot ana niya for one day, so wala na, disposable na siya, no? So di naman siya pwede gamiton og balik, no? So there are some other ways, no? So naay mga butang nga ma-recycle, na puy ubat butang nga dili. So next, now let us talk about the earth processes, no? So the earth processes includes earthquakes, landslides, floods, and volcanic eruption, which can be hazardous to habitats. So geologists work to understand these processes well enough how these processes are triggered and to be avoided, no? So well, masulti na to class, hindi na ginato ni siya ma-avoid ning earthquake. So kay ang earthquake di man nato na ma-predict, tapos wagi makapugong gyud sa earthquake. Kundi ang atong buhaton na to is mag-design na lang ta og structure nga which makasakuan siya, no, maka-withstand, no, sa earthquake, no. So that is the only way nga kita makasurvive. And such as kining mga uban pang processes nga landslide, floods. Okay, ang landslide, matrigger ang nakatrigger pud sa landslide is more likely earthquakes, no. Then sa floods is more likely kana bitong sa weather na siya, no? So weather and climate. Then we have the volcanic eruptions. Ang volcanic eruptions, natural lang gina siya, no? Earth processes. Kaya ang volcanic eruptions, murag pamaagi na siya sa earth nga makapahungaw siya sa iyahang kainit, no? Okay. So which can be hazardous to habitants. Hazardous gid siya, no? Okay. But after this volcanic eruption class, ang volcanic eruption, makatabang po ni siya nga magpababa po sa temperature sa planet Earth. Anyway, natay separate discussion about these Earth processes, no? So as of now, so limit lang sa nato. So because of these Earth processes, geologists will provide maps and information about every area which has a history of such processes, so that it will guide the engineers how to avoid or sustain such processes over time. So ang trabaho sa geologist with regards ani for this earth processes, mag-locate sila sa ilahang mapa, mag-locate sila sa mapa ug asa to dapita tong mga lugar which are hazardous, no? So hazardous, which is dili siya ideal for building, no? Building construction. Then kung let us say for example na ay fault line, tapos kining area is bao nun, no? So okay man siya nga mag-build ta sa area nga bao nun, yun nga lang matagbaw po ka og maintenance, no? Then at the same time mas mo gasto kag dako, no? So why not dili ka mag why not nganong mag dito na lang di ka mag-build sa konde sa tiyong tarong bitaw nga lugar, which is wala kayo'y risk, no? Dili, wala si hazard, no? Okay, so wala pa siyo'y lugar nga wala hazard, pero kuan kaning less, no? Lesser hazard, no? Okay. Next. So that is the three, no? Three topics nga usually the geologists have to cover, no? So the earth history, earth materials, then the earth processes. Okay. So next. Since kini siya nga subject matter is talking about geology for civil engineers, so naatay term nga gitawag nato nga engineering geology, no? So what is engineering geology therefore? So engineering geology is a very important topic for structural engineers to understand most of the earth's processes as it helps them properly plan a project when considering the design, location, and other important geological factors. So because of this one class, no, ang kining mga study sa geology class, geologist, kining mga weather forecasters, not weather forecasters, no, ilahang mga gipangkandak ng study class, magamit na siya for engineering construction. Especially, such this one, no, those parameters such as the soil strength, soil classification, wind speed, gust, seismic factors, gravity, etc., were part of structural design considerations in order to make the structures or buildings sustain or withstand the force of nature as it happens, no? So mao gini siya ang primary purpose sa geology class, no? And ang more likely ang focus gyud sa engineering geology is about the structural, no? The structural aspect of the building. Unsaon nila pag-adjust sa ato ang gi-construct na building nga kaya niya mo sustain, no? Kanang kaya niya mo survive sa mga natural calamity o natural earth processes, no? So it also allows us to refrain from building structures that were labeled as hazard zones such as fault lines, sinkholes, landslides, and flood-prone areas. So that is engineering geology, no? Okay, so we'll now begin discussing about the earth. So ubay-ubay kining atong ma-discuss about sa earth, kay ang earth broad kayo ni siya, no? Dagan kay tag hisgutan sa earth. So usa kuan pa ni mahaba-habang inuman, no? Okay. So if we talk about earth, okay, so let us begin with the etymology. So asa man na nagikan ang word ng earth, no? So the earth is commonly described as the world, no? So in old English, no? Soil, the globe. So sometimes the earth is referred to that word, no? Sometimes if we say the world, they mean that is the earth, no? The soil, earth gyapon na siya, the globe, earth gyapon lang buot pasabot. So which derived from the old English. Sometimes it is spelled as iorde, no? Iorde. I don't know how to pronounce this one, no? Pero ibasin na lang nato according sa iyang text, no? Iorde, no? Iorde. So its Roman equivalent term is what we called as Terra, no? So taken from the Roman goddess Terra Mater, or which means Mother Earth, no? Then for Latin, it is known as Tellus, no? So which is common noun for land. So if we talk about sa Latin daw, ang equivalent daw sa word nga Tellus is land. So as we know nga ang if we say land or soil or world, we refer to the earth, no? While in Greek, it is known as Gaia, no? Gaia ang tawagan nila. Sometimes it is spelled as Gaia, E ang kwa, no? Instead nga I, Gaia. Which is the name of the ancestral mother of life, no? So, muna siya ay sinugdanan sa term nga or word nga, earth, no? Okay. So, chronology, no? So, let us say giunsa pag-form sa earth, no? So the earth is dated back around 4.5 billion years old based on the oldest fossil that has been recovered. So sa mga scientist, ang ilang estimations kung pila ka kuan, pila edad sa earth, so gibase nila sa pinaka oldest fossil nga ilahang na recover, which is dated back as 4.5 billion years old, no? Okay, so nauna-unin mo, no? Pila na katuig na gano'n. Okay, so in theory, so giyon sa pag-form ang Earth, In theory, a solar nebula partitions a volume out of a molecular cloud by gravitational collapse, which begins to spin and flatten into a circumstellar disk. So mura siya og kanang nagform siya og mura siyang solar system, no? Kanang nagtuyok ba? And then the planets grow out of that disk with the sun, no? Okay. So a leading hypothesis that the moon was a fragment of the earth, which is a result from the collision with the Mars-sized object with 10% of earth's mass named Theia, no? So ang kuan daw, ang pagka-form daw sa moon was gikan daw na siya sa collision, no, with the Mars-sized object, no, with the earth, no. So kitong nagbangga sa earth with the Mars-sized object, ang resulta baragkuan ba ang moon bari mo tapya siya sa earth, no. Okay, so next naman tayo mga daghan man kaya ng mga theory about sa creation sa solar system, no, natong mga big bang theory, no. So dil wala lang ta nagkuan, no, naglimit sa mga other theories, no. So so far gitawag yapon na siya nga theory is because wala pa'y makapamatuod. Pero kuan siya, no, matawag siya nga intellectual guess, no, ang theory. So daghang klaseng theory. Okay, so the earth therefore the earth before was only one landmass continent known as the Pangaea, no. Isa lang daw ang landmass sa una. Isa lang daw ang butang nato isla, no. Then the rest are water, no. So ang tawag atong kuan continent sa una is what we call as the Pangaea. The evolution of life forms began when chemical reactions led to the first replicating molecules about 4 billion years ago, no. So nagsugod daw ang life forms kana mga kuan mga organisms, so that will be 4 billion years ago, no. So the earliest direct evidence of life on earth is contained in 3.45 billion year old Australian rocks, no. So na ay kuan nagpamatuod nga ebidensya about sa ilahang na uncover, no, nga kanang fossil siguro, no, fossils of microorganisms which is dated back as 3.45 billion years ago, no. So modo na ilahang pamatuod nila nga during this time nag-exist dire nagsugod or nag-exist na ang life forms, no. Then the earth underwent at least 5 major and many minor extinction events, no. Extinction events muna siyang na ay mga species nga mga hurot, no. Okay, including the asteroid drop that triggers the extinction of dinosaurs and large reptiles, no. So to mga dinosaur, so famous man kayo ng mga dinosaur, no. Okay, so how does the dinosaur does not exist until now, no, ganong na-extinct sila. So what will be the reason for that? So possibly napun sila yung mga kuan, wala may tao nga na tao atong panahon. So ilahang theory is because of the asteroid drop, no. So that makes the dinosaurs extinct, no. Then it is predicted that the earth's long-term future depends on the sun's evolution, no. So sama sa mong i-mention ganiha na possibly ang future sa earth nagdepende po siya sa sun's evolution. So when the sun evolves into a red giant, no, oxygen will be depleted due to the absence of plants and survival of life will become impossible. So magkuan daw kung masobra na po daw kayo ang init, so ma-deplete daw, no, ma-deplete ang oxygen. Pasabot ana ma-deplete ang oxygen, mahurot ang oxygen, no. Kay kabalo mo class unsaon pag-deplete ani? Pag init kay ang kuan o sa ka lugar, 'di ba? In order for you to create fire, you need oxygen, no. So para magkuan class, para masunog siya, ikonsumo ang oxygen. So kagadto gayan, pag makonsumo ang oxygen at the same time, mahurot naman pud ang atong mga plants, no. Di naman ka-survive ang itong mga plants. Ang plants mo yung mag-provide ng oxygen, no? So wala na yung oxygen, mahurot na, no? So that might be the key that the survival of life will become impossible. Not unless kung ang organism mismo mag-kuan siya, no? Mag-evolve nga, di na siya mabuhay ng oxygen, no? Lain na lang. Okay, next. Okay, so let us now discuss about the chemical composition of the earth. So, unsa day ning earth made of, no? So, the earth's mass is approximately 5.97 times 10 raised to 24 kilograms or 5,970 yotagram, YG, no? Yotagram. So, times 10 raised to 24. So, yun na kabugat ang mass sa earth. So, it is composed mostly of iron, which is 32%, then oxygen, 30%, silicon, 15%, magnesium, mga 14%, okay, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so, abundant kayo nga to ang earth og iron, then oxygen, no? Okay, and the rest are the other elements that we can found on the periodic table, no? Okay, due to mass segregation, the core region of the core region is estimated to be primarily composed of iron, no? So possibly daw ang ilahang gi theory nila, wala pa man gi nakaabot dito sa may core region sa ato ang layer sa ato ang earth. So di kuan nila class ilahang gi tansya that the core region is made up of iron, which is 88% of iron. Then, small amounts of nickel, 5.8. Then, sulfur, which is 4.5. And less than 1% trace of elements. Okay, ang dinay sa may kilid class. Okay, this is the chemical composition of the crust, no? Sa crust ni siya. Kini siya sa core ni siya, no? Sa core region. Okay, kini siya sa general, no? Okay. So sa crust mo ni siya ang ato ang mga composition, no? Unsa nga mga elements siya made of. Okay. Next. Okay, the internal structure of the earth, no? So the outer layer is chemically distinct silicate solid crust, no? Which is underlain by a highly viscous solid mantle. Okay. So as we know class, ang crust na to, ang pinakadaghan o kuan, pinakaabundant og element sa ato ang crust is the silica, no? Una, silica sa may outer layer, silicate solid crust, no? So the crust is separated from the mantle by the Mohorovicic discontinuity. So unsa rin ang Mohorovicic discontinuity? So it is a boundary between the earth's crust and the mantle. Kining green diri class nga makita nato diri sa may layer, that is what we called as the Mohorovicic discontinuity, no? So the thickness of this crust varies from 6 kilometers under the oceans to 30 to 50 for the continents, no? Okay, next. Okay. So ang atong internal structure na to class or ang layers sa to ang earth is more likely atong nibal-an nato is crust, mantle, tapos outer core and the inner core. So, naay tendency class nga ang atong crust nagcombine sila with the upper mantle. And that layer is what we called as the lithosphere, no? So, lithosphere is the highly viscous layer. Unsa may pasabot ang highly viscous? Ang highly viscous mo na siyang lapot, no? Kanang iyang property niya is somewhat liquid siya pero kanang less movable, no? Less shaky, no? Okay, so highly viscous layer which is composed of entire crust and a solid upper mantle. The actinosphere is a low viscous layer composed of liquid mantle on which the lithosphere floats. So low viscous, meaning to say, medyo shaky siya or iyang characteristic is somewhat mura siya o tubig, no? Kana lihukan kayo, no? Okay, so low viscosity. Okay, so mo na siya astenosphere. Ubos na siya sa lithosphere nga maoy gi lutaw-lutawan sa tuang lithosphere ang kanang astenosphere, no? Okay. So ubos anang sa astenosphere is what we called as the outer core. Beneath the mantle is the low viscous outer core which just lies above the solid inner core. So ang inner core na to, so the radius of the inner core is about 1/5 of that earth, no? Now, pangutan na o giunsa na nila pag kuan giunsa nila pag calculate sa gilaw mo niya, well, I don't know, no. Sila ra ginahibaw ani. So wala man puy naka tripod o kalot, no, or let us say dig gikan sa surface down to the inner parts of the earth, no. So far wa pa ko kakita nga naay nag himog tunnel. Yun nga lang naman nag-try pero wala sila kabalo, no. Okay. Kay dili pa man lang gidaan sa may laba dapit dili na mag-survive ang ilang equipment, no. So masunog na ilang equipment, malanay. Okay. So what will be the internal structure, no? Or let's say na we are talking now with the internal structure. So why is it nga those layers mulutaw sila na uban mulugdang, no? Okay. So that is we based that one according to density, no? The lesser the density of the material or the layer, the more siya nga mulutaw. Pero the denser, or let us say, the greater the value of the density of the layer, the more siya nga mo paadto sa ilalom. So, anong ang inner core na sa ilalom is because yung density niya is nag-range between 12.8 to 13.1. Somewhat ang ato ang crust is naa siya sa 2.2 to 2.9. The upper mantle is 3.4 to 4.4. Lower mantle, 3.4 to 5.6. No? Then the outer core is 9.9 to 12.2. No? It's just somewhat similar lang na class, no? Kung mag-experiment, bitaw mo, i-mix ninyo ang different liquid. No? Let us say, oil, tapos water, tapos seawater. Unsa pa may pwede nato mag-combine nato nga kuan. So this mercury, no. So mercury, seawater, normal water, tapos oil, no. Kung i-try nimo na silang mix class, okay, na tendency nga mukuan na sila, no, mag-separate na sila, no. Okay, maghimo silang separate layers. So ilang i-arrange lang ilang kagalingon according sa ilang density, no? So yung unana na siya, no? Okay, so that explains how, no, nganong ingunana ang atoang structure, inner internal structure sa earth. Okay, let us talk about heat, no. As we know that the earth nagproduce po siya og sariling heat, no. So what makes the earth produce its own heat, no? So the major heat producing isotopes, unsa dayon ang isotopes? Isotopes are variants of the particular chemical element which differ in neutron number and consequently in nucleon number. Okay. So, ang atong major heat producing isotopes class is the potassium, uranium, and thorium, no? Kining si potassium class, well, we are no kanang kuan kay no, common kini sa tuan ni potassium. Yun nga lang, ang laing variant sa potassium, which is potassium 40, kuan siya, no? Heat producing. Then, ang uranium 238, heat producing po ni sila, no? Then, napuntay 235 ng uranium, which is the stable, no? The stable type of variant. Then, napuntay thorium, no? So, among this elements class, na yung mga elements di rin, murag usually ginagamit nato for daily life, pero ang ilang laing variant delikado, no, naay uban na ay radioactive, no. Okay, so radioactive. So with this one class, ang ilang pagproduce nilag pagproduce nilag heat is somewhat mura siya og ano kanang yang process is kana bitong magseparate og kanang magshare sila og kanang mga electrons, no, electrons and neutrons, no. Bale magkuan sila, no, ang ilang each molecule murag magshare sila, then ang kana siya nga process is what we call as the half-life, no. Okay, half-life. Bale magsige sila og kanang segregate pay tawagan ang term, kanang magsige bitaw og kanang bulag, murag gina-divide lang ko galingon by half, no, each time, no. So every time nga magkuan sila class, mag separate sila, nag-create na siya og energy, and that energy converts into a heat, no. So, muna siya, no? So, all isotopes of a given element have the same number of protons but different numbers of neutrons in each atom. So, that explains why, no? So, muna siya, no? So, the Earth is also abundant with this type of elements which is needed to produce heat, no? Okay, next. Okay, tectonic plates. So, tectonic plates. So, if we talk about the lithosphere, di ni mawala ning term nga tectonic plates. So, that the lithosphere was divided into tectonic plates. So, these plates are rigid segments that move relative to each other at one of the three boundary types, no? So, three boundary types na to. The convergent boundary. Where the convergent boundary, it means two plates come together kanang mag kuano kanang mag magsugat, no? Then we have this divergent boundaries, which is the two plates are pulled apart, meaning to say magbulag sila, no? Magbulag. Then naatay gitawag nga transform boundaries, which means two plates slide past one another laterally kanang nag kuan sila, no? Murag nagsagi, no? Pero separate ang ilahang direksyon, no? Okay, so along these plate boundaries, earthquakes, volcanic activity, mountain building, and oceanic transformation can occur, no? So, kasagaran diya sa kanang mga boundaries, diha mag-exist ang mga earthquake, volcanic activity. Okay, so natay separate discussion about this one. Kung if we talk about earthquakes and volcanic eruption, no? Okay, so ato na lang siyang i-discuss in detail dito sa kadong chapter. Okay, so the Earth's major plates. Ang Earth na to na siya ay major plates. Because of the formation of the tectonic plates, no? So, ang Earth na to na divide into different plates, no? So, among these Earth's major plates, we have this what we call as the Pacific plate. Then, natay African plate, North American plate, natay Eurasian, as mandapitan ng Eurasian. So that is the combination of Europe and Asia, no? So may bandang Asia and Europe. Murag likod na ning kuan niya, likod na ni siya sa may Asia, no? Sa may China or sa may Middle East dapit, no? Okay. Then we have Antarctic plate sa may baba, no? Then the Indo-Australian plate, which is sa may Australia, no? Dire, sa may kining orange, no? Then we have the South American plate dire, no? So may baba sa kining color violet. Okay. Next. So far ang pinakadako dire nga kuan major plate is the Pacific plate, no? Okay, the surface, no? The surface of the Earth, no? So the surface of the Earth, no? So the total surface of the Earth is equivalent to 510 million square kilometer, no? So, inguna na kadako ang ilahang na-compute nilang surface area sa Earth, no? And from that surface area, there are 71% of this area is covered with ocean water. And the remaining is 29%, no? Is land. Okay. Yuta na ang 29%, the rest is 71% of water. So, erosions and tectonics, volcanic eruptions, flooding, weathering, glaciation, the growth of coral reefs and meteorite impacts are among the processes that constantly reshape the Earth's surface over geological time, no? So, the continental crust consists of lower density material such as the igneous rocks, granite, and andesite. Okay, so with regards sa kanang kwan class, kining different types of rocks, so natay separate po nga chapter, ana. So, limit lang kayo na itong discussion about ano, no? Okay, next. Okay, so let us discuss about the magnetosphere, no? So ang ato ang Earth class, napod na siya ay magnetic field. So what makes the Earth produces a magnetic field? So ang kung nakahinumdom mo sa kuan class sa iyang inner core or the core itself, mo na siya nag-provide og magnetic field. As we know that the inner core is made of iron. So made of metal siya. So, ang metal class na siya ay magnetism, no? So, with this magnetic field class, ang magnetic field na to, sa Earth, dako kayong siyang tabang is because ang kaning kuan class magnetic field na to nagserve siya as a shield, no? Shield para sa kaning solar wind, which is kanang giproduce sa sun. So because of this shield class, dili tama grabihan og expose sa init sa adlaw, no? Okay. So because of this one class, the Earth's magnetic field serves as the shield against the materials carried by the solar wind. Those materials' radiation would do severe damage to any life forms on Earth if reached the planet's surface. So because of this magnetic field class, gipugnan niya nga moabot ang radiation sa surface sa Earth. Once nga moabot na ang kuan class radiation sa Earth, posible nga maka-damage sa mga life forms, no, or makapatay siya, no, sa mga nagpuyo. Okay, so ions and electrons of the solar wind are deflected by the magnetosphere. So solar wind pressure compresses the day side of the magnetosphere to about 10 Earth radii, no, and extends the night side magnetosphere into a long tail, no. Okay, so ingon na yung process. So let us say, for example, nag-image siya ang sun o solar wind. So ang solar wind na to, instead nga muagi siya diretso dire, okay, iyahang i-divert niya, no? I-divert niya ang solar wind into different side. Nga iyahang entry points, dili siya maka-harm, no? Iyahang i-compress, no? Okay. So the main part of the Earth's magnetic field is generated into the core, no? Generated in the core. So the site of the dynamo process that converts the kinetic energy of thermally and compositionally driven convection into electrical and magnetic field energy. Okay. So how does the magnetic or how does the core produces a magnetic field, no? Okay, ang iyang buhaton niya, class. Okay, so by means of dynamo process, no? Nga, i-convert niya ang kinetic energy into electrical and magnetic field energy. So, munang na ay magnetic field, no? So, tungod sa iyahang element or let us say composition, no? Sa iyahang core, no? So, i-convert niya ang iyang kinetic into electrical and magnetic field. So, that is why naatay magnetic field. And kung mapansin ninyo, class, the geographic North Pole is the magnetic South Pole, no, sa ato ang magnet. Okay, so ganong magnetic South Pole man siya, let us say for example, or okay, so nalibog ko, tipa the geographic North Pole, meaning to say geographic North Pole kanang mismong sa ato ang geography, no, location sa North Pole. Then ang iyang magnetism niya is south. Okay, so no wonder nga if ever magtan-aw ta sa tong compass, class, ang atoang north nato mo-attract dito sa may south, no? Ang south nga magnetic south dito sa may North Pole, matudlo niya kung asa dapit ang location sa North Pole. It's because ang atoang magnet nato is north man siya, no? So ang north mo-attract sa south, which is ang south located sa may North Pole, no? Okay. Libog, no? Okay, nalibog po gani ko. Okay. So natay gitawag nga Van Allen radiation belt, no? Is a zone of the energetic charge particle, so most of which originate from the solar wind. So there are that are captured by and held around a planet by the planet's magnetic field. So ang purpose aning kuan, class, kining Van Allen radiation belt is magsilbi siya nga maoy mo capture sa radiation. So inigintrada sa solar wind, class, ang katong iyang radiation niya magtuyok-tuyok rito siya diri sa kilid gawas sa planet Earth, no? Okay. So because of this magnetism, class, no, so dako kay ning tabang ning atoang magnetism sa atoang Earth or sa atoang planet Earth. Otherwise, kung wala yung magnetism, class, so wala, no? Wala tay, sa tawag ini, wala tay mura og kanang barrier or shield, o wala tay mura kanang safety, no? Okay. Wala tay safety from the influence of the outside, no? Okay, so next is we will discuss about the Earth's orbit and rotation. So the Earth's rotation period relative to the Sun, or let us say it means solar day, is about 86,400 seconds, no, of mean solar time. So kung i-convert mo ng 86,400 seconds, that is equivalent to 24 hours, no? Then the Earth's orbit, the Earth orbits the Sun at an average distance of 150 million kilometer. So that is mga equivalent na siya sa 93 million miles, no? So every 365.2564 mean solar days or one sidereal year, no? So no wonder nga ang atoang kwan class, ang atoang kalendaryo, that is composed of equivalent to 365 days, no? So ang yahang entire revolution niya sa Sun, no? So that is 365. So kung since nga naman siya exists, posible nga mo experience taog leap year, no? So if we say leap year, so instead nga 365, mahimo siyang 366, no? Okay. So the orbital speed of Earth averages about 29.78 kilometers per second, no? Ang iyang orbital speed sa tuong Earth. So the Moon and Earth orbit a common barycenter every 27.32 days relative to the background stars, no? So when combined with the Earth-Moon system common orbit around the Sun, the period of the synodic month from new moon to new moon is equivalent to 29.53 days. So no wonder nga to ang kalendaryo class every month is equivalent to 30 days, no? Average. Okay. Next. The orbital and axial planes are not precisely aligned. So dili sila aligned ang ilahang orbital and axial planes. So Earth's axis is tilted. Tilted some 23.44 degrees from the perpendicular to the Earth Sun plane, no? And for the Earth Moon plane, it is tilted for about more or less 5.1 degrees against Sun Earth Earth Sun plane, no? Okay. So without this tilt class, kung wala daw nining tilt daw, let us say ang atoang kwan ba, ang atong Earth is nagtuyok siya nga naka-tilt siya daan, no? So kung wala daw nining tilt class, imagine ninyo, there would be an eclipse every 2 weeks, no? Alternating between lunar eclipse and solar eclipse. So magsige ra tag eclipse class kung wala tay tilt, no, sa atoang Earth. So in modern times, the Earth's perihelion occurs about January 3, no? And its aphelion around July 4, no? So unsa day ning perihelion and aphelion? Ang perihelion is the nearest distance from Earth to Sun, no? Then ang atuang aphelion is the farthest distance from Earth to Sun. Okay, so the axial and tilt seasons, no? Ang kining axial og tilt the axial tilt class nag-contribute po ni siya sa tuang seasonal change, no? So the axial tilt of the Earth, as we know, is 23.44 degrees with the axis of its orbit plane always pointing towards the celestial poles, no? So due to Earth's axial tilt, the amount of sunlight reaching any given point on the surface varies over the course of the year, no? So this causes the seasonal change in climate, with summer in the northern hemisphere occurring when the Tropic of Cancer is facing the Sun, while winter ang mahitabo sa Tropic of Capricorn in the southern hemisphere when winter taking place when the Tropic of Capricorn in the southern hemisphere faces the Sun, no? So that explains why, no, nga naa tay seasonal change, no? Okay. Then we have this Earth-Moon system, no? So gravitational attraction between the Earth and Moon system, the gravitational attraction between the Earth and the Moon causes tides on Earth, no? So but pasabot class, ang dahilan di ay nga naay balon sa dagat is because of the moon, no? Kung wala yung moon, wala siguro yung balon, no? Possibly, possibly. Okay. So the same effect on the moon that has led to its tidal locking, no? So its rotation period is the same as the time it takes to orbit Earth, no? So therefore, as a result, it always presents the same face to the planet. But pasabot nga mao nang parehas ra day gihapon ang dagway sa moon nga tong makita is because kanang is because of the rotation itself, which is equivalent lang siya sa the same lang gihapon siya sa orbit sa Earth. So mo nang ang naong sa moon, well, ang moon ba wala siya nagtuyok, no? Nagapirmi lang, nagatubang sa tua, no? So so far wala pa ta kakita sa dark side sa moon, no? Or the separate the opposite part sa moon, wala kita kakita. It's because ang moon niya nakalak lang siyang ihang naong niya nakalak lang gid siya sa tua, no? Okay. So as the moon orbits Earth, different parts of the face are illuminated by the sun, leading to the lunar phases. So due to their tidal interaction, the moon recedes from Earth at the rate of approximately 38 millimeters, no, in a year. Okay, the moon may have dramatically affected the development of life by moderating the planet's climate. Okay, so muna siya ang diameter sa moon, no, the mass itself and its semi-major axis, no. Okay, so next is let us discuss about the hydrosphere. So the Earth's hydrosphere consists chiefly of the oceans, but technically includes all water surfaces in the world, including the inland seas, lakes, rivers, and underground waters down to the depth of 2,000 meters, no? So about 97.5% of water is saline, meaning to say medyo parat-parat, no? Then the remaining is 2.5% is fresh water. The remaining 2.5. Okay. So the average salinity of Earth's ocean is about 35 grams of salt per kilogram of seawater. That is 3.5% of salt. So most of this salt was released from the volcanic activity or extracted from the cold igneous rocks. So sa to pa, ang nakaparat di sa dagat di ay is because of the volcanic activity, no, and or the kining mga salt which is extracted from the igneous rocks. So modern is dahilan nganong parat ang dagat, no. Okay, so it's because the volcanic activity and the salt that is extracted from igneous rocks. So the oceans are also a reservoir of dissolved atmospheric gases which are essential for the survival of many aquatic life forms, no? So dissolved, no, atmospheric gases. So the seawater has the important influence in the world's climate, with the oceans acting as a large heat reservoir, no? So ang atoang kwan class, ang seawater class, natay kwan, no, kanang kung mapansin ninyo, during summer bugnaw ang tubig, then sa may land areas is init. Pero ginig mga kuan, winter, init ang dagat, tapos ang sa may land areas is bugnaw. Okay, so how can we explain that one, class, no? Okay, so ang explanation anak niya, class, is because the more nga magsigig kuan, class, kanang mainitan ang dagat, class, mo kuan na siya, mo absorb na siya og init, no? So let us say for example, mag-start ta sa summer, no? So bugnaw ang dagat, no? So during summer, class, ang dagat maganam-anam na siya og absorb og heat gikan during summer. Pag mag-change season na siya, mahimo na siyang winter. Ang winter, class, bugnaw man ang winter, bugnaw ang land. So tama-tama pag-abot og winter, init na ang dagat, no? So munang init ang dagat, tapos bugnaw ang yuta. Then pag-abot na pud og season sa summer, since nga ang kuan class kanang bugnaw man ang land areas tapos na expose man ang tubig sa dagat sa yuta nga which is bugnaw, ang kuan class ang temperature sa yuta ganam-anam og suyop sa dagat sumao nang pagabot sa summer ni bugnaw na pud ang dagat no during kadtong winter. Ang kadtong winter time sa land areas giabsorb niya no ang temperature no. So mo nang pagabot og summer, tama-tama pagabot sa summer, bugnaw ang dagat, balik, no? Okay. So that is how, no? The explanation, no? Okay. So shifts in the oceanic temperature distribution can cause significant weather shifts such as the El Niño or the Southern Oscillation. Okay, so let us now discuss about the atmosphere, no? So the atmospheric pressure of the Earth sea level averages from 101.325 kilopascal, no? Try ninyo ni siya og memorize, no? Magamit yun ni siya sa inyo hangguan, no? If we talk about pressure or atmospheric pressure with a scale height of 8.5 kilometers. So the dry atmosphere is composed of 78% of nitrogen, 20% or 21% of oxygen, then 1% of argon, and the other one is trace amounts of carbon dioxide and other gaseous molecules. So water vapor content varies between okay, mga ginagmay na siya. So the Earth's biosphere has significantly altered its atmosphere. So unsa day ning biosphere? Ang biosphere class, it means na muna siya ang murag areas that are more likely composed of trees, mga vegetation, biosphere, no? So ang ato ang mga trees, mga plants, mo na siya ga-produce og kanang oxygen. So possibly nga if ever nga nay may tabo sila hang numbers or let us say mabawasan ang ilang numbers sa tuang Earth's biosphere, significantly malesen ang mga malesen tong mga plants or kidong mga kuan, no? Mga organisms nga mag-produce og oxygen, no? Okay, makakuan siya, no? Ma-alter gyud siya. So that is why kung kwanta, kung magkatag trees, atong pulihan, no? Okay, so i-conserve na to ang ato ang mga plants, no? Okay, next. So the oxygenic photosynthesis evolved 2.7 giga, no? Forming nitrogen oxygen atmosphere of today, no? So this change enabled the proliferation of aerobic organisms, no? And indirectly the formation of ozone layer due to the subsequent conversion of atmospheric O2 into O3. So the ozone layer blocks ultraviolet solar radiation permitting life on Earth, no? Permitting life on land, no? So ang kuan class, since ang ato ang biosphere, nag-produce silang oxygen, muabot na siya dito sa may atmosphere, mo process na ang iyahang oxygenic photosynthesis, no? Which makes the oxygen evolves into, gikan sa oxygen, o let us say O2, mahimo siyang O3, no? So because of this process class, that makes the creation of ozone layer, no? So mo nang dako yung kayo o gamit ang ato ang mga trees or maleta sa mga vegetation, no? Okay, aside sa the greater the number of oxygen, possibly nga the more nga mas daghan ang oxygenic photosynthesis and the more siya nga baga ang ato ang ozone layer, no? Okay, the more nga ozone layer nga atong ma-produce, no? Okay. So other atmospheric functions important to life include transporting water vapor, providing useful gases, causing small meteors to burn up before they strike the surface, no? So mapod ni siya yung maka advantage aning ato ang atmospheric other functions of atmospheric function, no? So the water vapor, no? So because of the water vapor providing useful gases, then causing small meteors to burn up before they strike on the surface and moderating the temperature. So kung naay nag-moderate og temperature class, napuntay ginatawag nga greenhouse effect, no? So unsay din ang greenhouse effect? Ang greenhouse effect class is magsilbi na siya nga i-trap ang init, no? I-trap ang init diri sa ang init nga gikan sa sun, ihang irradiate niya, ihang murag kuan ba kung sa kuan pa i-trap niya siyahang boundary, no? So after nga makasulod ang kuan, ang init gikan sa sun, iyahang i-deflect niya, ibalik tapod niya sa yuta, no? So i-deflect niya, maabot sa atmosphere, ang atmosphere i-deflect tapod niya balik sa yuta, no? Okay. So unsay purpose aning greenhouse effect? Okay, without this heat retention effect class, the average surface temperature would be negative 18 degrees Celsius. Kung wala daw ning greenhouse effect, no? So ang atong temperature sa Earth, it will be negative 18. So asa mo maka-survive kaya ang tao ng negative 18 degrees Celsius? So may na lang din ning kuno, no, naatay greenhouse effect is because of this greenhouse effect, ang atong temperature is nasa sa current of positive 15 degrees Celsius, no? Kaysa naman sa negative. Kaya kung negative, perte kinatog na waklas, no? Okay, and the life of the Earth possibly could not exist, no, to its current form kung walay greenhouse effect, no? So what are the unsay mga kuan class, no, nga ato ang mga greenhouse unsay nga mga elements nga maka-cause o greenhouse, no? Okay, natay mga natural greenhouse, no, which is the water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, and the ozone, no. Mo na sila yung mga greenhouse gases, no, sa tuang atmosphere. Okay, so naagin sila yung purpose gihapon, no. Okay, so di lang maayo kung sobra. Okay, the human geography, no. So the Earth's human population past 7 billion, no. 7 billion na daw ang population sa Earth, no. Population sa mga tao sa Earth. Okay. So the Earth has resources that have been exploited by humans, no. So ang tanan mga resources sa Earth ginagamit sa humans and gina-exploit, no? So by 2050, no, 68% of the world's population is expected to be living in urban rather than rural areas. Then 68% of the landmass of the world is in northern hemisphere. Since nga kasagarang yuta, or let us say partly due to the predominance of the landmass, is naa siya mismo sa may northern hemisphere, no? Kung makita ninyo ang atong mga kuan class, mga continent, na siya kasagaran pabor sa northern hemisphere. So 90% of humans live in the northern hemisphere therefore. Okay, so this kining nasa my right side, this are the percentage land use, no, as of 2015. So ang cropland nato is nasa mga 12 to 14%, pastures 30 to 47%. Then human-used forest, 16 to 27%. Infrastructure, 1%. So may ganit, kigamay pag infrastructure, no? So, dagan-dagan, ubay-ubay pa ang ato ang kuwan sa Earth, no? So, unused land is 24 to 31%. So, pastures, no? Kinimura siya o kuwan. That's it, no? Pastures. Okay, so mo lang ni siya nga itong i-discuss sa human geography. So limit na lang na itong mga ubang discussion sa chapter sa tuang about sa planet Earth, no? So na ay mga detailed discussion about that one for the next chapter. So as of now, so that is the end of the chapter 1. Thank you, bye-bye.